What?
Hey everyone, I'm Dave with the Fragrance Bros. Of course, your best source for everything fragrance related. Today, we're gonna do a topic that is a little bit controversial, I guess. We're talking about cannabis and fragrances. Now, just a little disclaimer here. I have never smoked any type of cannabis, but regardless of that, there's no judgment here. I just wanna talk about some cannabis related fragrances because I know there are a lot of people out there who do like it. And regardless of where you are in the issue, there are a number of fragrances that have cannabis in there because people actually like the smell. So today I'm gonna give you the 411 on 420 fragrances. Also too, let's not turn the comments into a cluster of controversy. All right, so the first one is Cannabis Flower from Demeter Fragrance Library. Demeter Fragrance Library is a company that I haven't talked a lot about on this channel, but I actually have a couple of their fragrances that I haven't shown you yet. I got them for my birthday one year from Talia, and I need to show those to you. But anyway, they make a lot of kind of photorealistic fragrances, and they have a lot of really avant-garde fragrances out there like Wet Garden and Baby's Head. So they have a lot of them, but they have other ones that are a little bit more normal, like some that are based on flowers. This one obviously is based on the cannabis flower. And being that it is a photorealistic portrayal, this is, it smells exactly like the cannabis flower. Cannabis flower is actually the main ingredient for marijuana. So it smells like freshly unlit marijuana, apparently. They describe it as slightly floral, slightly spicy, but unmistakably cannabis. And that's definitely the case. It definitely has a cannabis feel, but it's not skunky, it's not skanky, and it's not smoky. It's just kind of just the unlit, fresh, floral aspects of that. So really good. And it's really cheap. It's like $36 for, what is it, 100 mil? Yeah, $36 for 100 mil. All right, next is a fragrance that you knew was gonna be on this list. This one is Black Afghano by Nasamato. Now, Nasamato is a house, another house that I haven't really talked much about on here. They're a very interesting house, and this is a very interesting fragrance. This is really the conceptual opposite of the previous fragrance, where cannabis flower is kind of light and airy and somewhat floral. Black Afghano is dark and dense and heavy and very woody, and very much in the cannabis realm. Apparently this is supposed to evoke the best qualities of hashish, and so that's supposed to be what it's reminiscent of. As for the way it smells, I mean, it is as dark and as black as the juice is, and the juice is pitch black. If you like dark scents, this is probably the king of dark scents. It is darkness personified, and for that it is really, really interesting. It's also super beast mode. Like if there was a level beyond beast mode, Black Afghano would be that. I mean, it lasts upwards of 24 hours on your skin even after you've taken a shower. The company of Nasamato is a very interesting company. They are very artistic, and they don't give samples or bottles to anyone at all. So if you want to smell it at all, you have to go to a place that actually sells it or buy it yourself. But if you really like that type of scent, the really dark, heavy, woody, spicy, cannabis flavor type of scent, then you definitely need to go hunt this one out. It's definitely worth it. All right, next is Hungry Hungry Hippies by Smellbent Perfumes. Smellbent is a really funny house. They're a much needed breath of fresh air in a fragrance world that takes themselves way too seriously. Hungry Hungry Hippies, obviously from the name, is supposed to be reminiscent of edibles. And in a nutshell, it is pot brownies. So you have chocolate, you have cinnamon, you have cannabis, and you have patchouli all mixed into one. And it is really good. If you like any or all of those things, you have got to check out Hungry Hungry Hippies. It is one of the best cannabis scents, I think, out there. And I'm a big fan of gourmands in general, so I'm kind of biased in that direction. But as someone who doesn't love cannabis in general, I think this one is really good. It'll give you the munchies too. All right, next is a trio of fragrances from House of Matriarch. Now, House of Matriarch sells several different trios of their lines. They have a big line, but they have these little kind of travel-sized sprayers that come in trios of different kind of flavors and genres. This one in particular is their cannabis trio, I believe they call it. But anyway, it's based on cannabis. So you have Black Number One, Forbidden and Sex Magic. And I believe these are 20 mils, if I'm not mistaken. But it's really good, especially if you don't want full bottles of all these. This is a great way to try out their line. We'll start with Black Number One here. Black Number One is a really complex scent. And actually, this is their most complex scent in the line. And it is very pungent and woody. It has oud and obviously cannabis in there. It's leathery, rich, dark, and complex. And there's a lot of facets to this to really hook your nose onto. The cannabis, while it's there, it's not dominant in the fragrance. And I think I forgot to mention, this has over 298 ingredients in it. So there's a lot in here. Next is Forbidden. Forbidden is a really interesting concept because a lot of the notes in here have been forbidden throughout history. So it starts with absinthe, and then it develops into tobacco, cannabis, mushroom, and then there is a floral backdrop that kind of holds it together of tuberose. Overall, this is a very intoxicating floral scent that is racy and scandalous and almost has like a spiritual vibe that I really like here. The cannabis is noticeable in this one, but I think everything is very well balanced as far as the mix. All right, next is Sex Magic, and I have no idea if this is actually magically sexual because my wife doesn't really care for this. And this one has a lot of wood in it. So it has pine, cedar, oud, some other woody notes. It has leather, violet, sandalwood, amber. And I do get a little bit of a saffron type of smell in there too. It's very interesting, almost incense-y. And so yeah, that's the Cannabis Trio by House of Matriarch. Really check those out, really good. Next is a fragrance that I'm really excited about. And that one is Cosé O2 by Parfumerie Générale. This is probably the best tobacco scent ever. It is amazing. It's not necessarily a cannabis forward fragrance, but the cannabis actually adds a lot here. Now, Cosé O2 is supposed to be inspired by a cigar case owned by the father of the perfumer of this line. And whenever you smell it, it smells just like a luxurious cigar box. I don't really know that much about cigars, but the cannabis in this really brings out kind of a pungent cigar-like quality in the tobacco that is very nice. And there's other notes in here that kind of make it a little bit more round and full. So there's Indian hemp, patchouli, coffee, pimento, pepper, sandalwood, ebony wood, cedar, tobacco, and bourbon vanilla. This one I could almost consider in the gourmand territory. It's very rich, warm, full, almost edible with that vanilla and the bourbon. And it, it is really cozy. And it is, again, just one of the best smelling tobacco scents out there. I love this stuff. Can't wait to wear this in the cooler weather. Next is Omniscent by Yoche. Yoche is a great house that I really, really love. Most of her line is either feminine or unisex, though she does have two very masculine scents, Koenig and Sombre Negro, which are incredible. But this one is one of the unisex scents, and the name, I believe, is wordplay on the word omniscient, which I think is very interesting because this is a very spiritual type of scent. Yoche Han has a line that has that kind of spiritual flavor to them. And this one, it smells a little bit like the experience that you get in like a head shop, kind of. So if you've ever been in like a head shop or maybe even like a kind of a CD tattoo parlor, then you know that kind of scent that I'm talking about. There is something about the kind of incense-y, hypnotic aroma that they have in there that is attractive and almost repulsive and almost spiritual. It's a lot of different kind of contrasts there, and this one is exactly that. Definitely cannabis in here, but there's more to it. There's some white flowers, there's incense, there's smoke, there's woods, there's also spices, and it's one of those fragrances, like I said, that has a very spiritual quality and dynamic, and it almost has a altered consciousness type of feel to it, which is kind of strange, but intriguing at the same time. Next is Smoke for the Soul from Bykillian. Bykillian is a great house that I really like, and there are some fragrances that they have that are just some of the best in class. I mean, they're incredible. Smoke for the Soul is one of the better fragrances in the Addictive State of Mind collection. That whole collection is actually very good. Addictive State of Mind, obviously, is supposed to be reminiscent of cannabis. And they say that it flirts with a forbidden herb, which is very subtle. Now, there's no cannabis actually listed in the notes, but just from their description, and then from the smell, I mean, it's a weed scent. You can definitely, definitely get that right away. Floral, green, herbal, spicy, all the qualities that you're looking for in a kind of hemp, cannabis type of smell, it's there. Now, this one is a lighter fragrance as far as the way it feels. It does last a good amount, but it doesn't feel heavy, which some of these fragrances do. So I really like this because it has that kind of lightness that I would be looking for in kind of a green scent in general. It's really good. Green, sappy, spicy, herbal, and a little bit smoky. It's really good. And last on the list is Kinski. Now, Kinski is a fragrance that was named after the actor Klaus Kinski from the 70s and 80s. And this one is unabashedly about marijuana. I mean, unabashedly. They say that in the description. The notes are explicitly marijuana. And that is exactly what it smells like. But it is really good. It has a nice fullness to it. It kind of has all the best qualities of a cannabis type of smell without the negatives. So again, it's not skunky and it's not dank. It's just a really good green scent. You'll find that when you wear this, you'll actually get more compliments. And some people will like the smell and they'll compliment you and they don't really know what it is. And which I don't know what that says about them necessarily. But it's one of the best straight up cannabis scents out there. If you're looking for just straight up cannabis, check out Kinski. So that's all I have. Let me know what you think of these choices. And if you have another cannabis scent that you like, let me know down in the comments. Of course, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe on the way out. I'll love you for it. I'll see you next time. I'm David with the Fragrance Bros. Bye. Thanks everyone for watching. If you like this video, don't forget to check out my other channel, Beast Made Reviews, where me and a friend review high quality products for men. You might like it. Go check it out.